Hi, I'm John Bradford, the Chief Technical Officer at Generation Orbit. At GO, we're building a team to develop a new low-cost propulsive stage that will support the emerging market for returning high-value payloads from orbit. While the aerospace industry has been focused on developing new launch vehicles for access to space, there has been almost no consideration for returning payloads from space. Of the current options that exist, they simply cannot provide the required frequency, price, and capability that are now needed. Over the last year, we've been working to mature and rapidly field this new low-cost system. It is specifically tailored to support the orbit capabilities required for safely bringing small payloads back to Earth. Our solution is centered around the use of a new green monopropellant fuel. As a high-performance alternative to hydrazine, this fuel eliminates the handling, toxicity issues, and operational impacts associated with legacy monoprops. Compared to a biprop solution, we get the benefit of a high-performance system while minimizing the design complexity. Referred to as the MPDS, or Monopropellant Deorbit Stage, our system also provides communications, power, attitude control, and a payload interface. This permits us to sustain on-orbit operations as a free flyer for periods of up to 6 months. Under our phase one effort with AFWERX, we have refined and further optimized the system based on several unique constraints that precision deorbit places on the system. We have taken a holistic approach to our design, envisioning the future integrated solution and considering all aspects that will impact the propulsive stage from launch through recovery of the payload return system. We have constrained our system's physical size to be compatible with rideshare opportunities, ensuring we have multiple low-cost options for launch. And while the requirements for deorbit drive the system design, MPDS also provides a cost-competitive and highly capable solution for other in-space markets, such as servicing as an in-space tug, removing orbital debris, and support for satellite servicing. While our technology, we also aim to reduce the existing backlog of on-orbit experiments within the DoD and provide an affordable, agile environment for technology maturation. Proceeding in earnest to develop the system, we have also initiated a risk reduction program with internal corporate funds. In less than 3 months, we designed, fabricated, and conducted cold flow testing for the monopropellant thruster. Over the next few months, we will conduct hot fire testing in order to collect valuable information on our design, as well as gain experience handling the fuel. Thank you for your time, and we look forward to providing additional details and vision about our technology.